the what you see is another mirror, and it just keeps going and going and going and going. That's what it looked like.
Yeah. Oh well. Hey, holy shit. Hey, I think we're live.
Oh,
So hey,
fuck.
this is the Spaniard here, BlackSheep Bravo, coming at you, keeping it tight. It is Friday night. It is March 9th, and that means only one thing. That is our BlackSheep Bravo Roundtable live show. So talk amongst yourselves. I'm gonna try. I'm just gonna try one more time because I hate to give up. I'm gonna try giving our intro here one more time. So talk amongst
All right, go
yourselves.
For it.
I'll be right back.
All right. We have a good show tonight, gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen. So log in, give us a comment, tell us what you think about the show. While the Spaniard tries his best to get this technical difficulties, as he says, is a work in progress.
Yeah, folks. I mean, give us a break here. We're not friggin' we don't have $1 million on equipment and friggin' software and interns and all these other goddamn people to help us out. So give us a break here. We got yeah. We'll get there eventually.
We're getting there, man.
Here's here's the intro.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's go.
All right, I think that was it. Hopefully it works. If it didn't, let us know. We'd like to hear from you. So we're going to switch back over. I think we're good. So, Doc, are we good? Are we live? We got verification? Do we have confirmation that we are on the air?
We
Fantastic.
Are on the air.
Fantastic. Well, gentlemen, it's just us today. I'd like to give a toast to making it to Friday. Down in one, gents. Here we go.
It's a lot to down in,
no, that's
in
not
one.
That's,
all right.
This brought to you by Sky Vodka. Sky Vodka was on sale for $14.99. So the trophy,
hey,
I bought three bottles. Trophy.
Bacardi and Coke.
Sky Vodka. Okay.
Blue Moon, gentlemen.
Blue Moon.
Blue Moon.
All right.
Moon.
How's my hair looking? Hair looking good
Do
today?
You actually know what a blue moon is?
No, I
where,
don't.
You know where it's at?
I know what a blue moon is. It is the second full moon in a month period.
Damn, wow, that's God. That college education for you, bro.
Holy shit.
It's working out for me.
Never amaze me. Always amaze me. Way to go, Doc.
When did you learn that, or did you always have that?
You know, I'm actually in an astronomy class right now, so I learned it maybe a month ago.
No shit. Astronomy. I never would have thought.
Yeah, I am totally fascinated with space and the origin of the universe, and it's just awesome Damn. Stuff to learn about.
How many chicks are in the class?
Oh, maybe like 2 out of 50.
Oh, all right, I was gonna
that's
say.
That's why he could focus.
Yeah, that's good. That's right. Focus on the right. stars, right?
Exactly.
Damn stars.
Yeah.
Well, what we got here is we got one of these stars. We call this one the. What do we call this? I don't know. I don't know why. I think of Northern Illinois. I'm thinking, you know, they talk like that. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. I'm sorry. That's wrong.
You're not too far away from Northern Illinois. I'm pretty sure we talk the same.
Well, yeah, I'm in Indiana, man. We just got back. We just zoomed from 1950 over to 2018. So I got no room to talk. So I guess
Fair
you're
enough.
Right. Fair enough. So we're going to go, go around. Well, first, thank you all for watching. It is another Friday night. We are a veteran-run show for veterans, by veterans, for veterans, and whoever wants to watch, because at this point in the game, if you're watching, we love it. We appreciate it. So thank you guys for watching. Please feel free to leave a comment. Doc is going to be monitoring that and to answer any and all your questions. So this is definitely interactive. We want to hear from you, so don't be afraid. So we're going to start off around the table. Unfortunately, several of our crew had some family commitments, so they're going to be missed, but we're going to go. The show must go on with or without them, so we're going to wish them well, and they'll be back next week. So we're going to start off, kick it off with – who wants to go first, gentlemen? Which
I'll
one
do it.
Doc. So, Doc, take it
away. Doc.
Tell us what's going on
the
in the lab.
The show must go on. All right. So you guys remember that one – can I really call him a friend? But that person – that I don't really know his name, but yet I'm still like his friend for some reason. So, I mean, I see him almost every single day, and I still haven't built up the courage Taster's name.
Come
this
on.
This is the guy you had lunch with the last time you talked about it.
And, and funny enough, on next Tuesday, I'm going to lunch with him again, having a beer.
Come on.
Wow.
So you know what? Hey, do you guys watch Parks and Rec? Or have you seen it?
Sometimes, on Netflix.
You're familiar with Ron Swanson, right? He's like the libertarian and the very like stout guy, I guess.
Is that the guy with the mustache?
Yeah, the mustache guy. But
yes.
one of his sayings was,
I don't know why I'm stroking it.
Best friend I ever had.
Yeah.
And he was talking about someone he never learned or he never talked to. And then it just reminded me of that. So that's pretty much it.
Damn.
That's how my day is going.
That was grueling, man. I was waiting for something profound to happen. Like you said, you're my twin, or you know, I fucking have your liver or something. Yeah.
Oh, I thought you figured the guy's name out.
Yeah. I wish, man.
It would make my life so much easier.
Man. Okay. Well. All right. Was that it?
Yeah. That was it.
Fucking A. Beautiful. Outstanding. We're gonna whisk over to the east side, where to the east, the Bronx. Bobby from the Bronx, Devil Dog, tell us what's going on in your neighborhood.
So welcome, everyone. Happy Friday. We had a tough snowstorm, but, you know, we went through it. You know, a couple of people lost power. And thank God, you know, my house is still up and running. We got full power. So today's going to be a great show, you know, because, you know, I woke up in a good mood, a very good mood, because I got reached out by somebody that actually saw our show and reached out to me. Oh, let me tell you something, gentlemen. Someone reached out to me and wanted me to share and plug their organization. I'm going to put it on the screen so you can see it real quick. It's called Hooked on Heroes. You see it? Hooked on Heroes.
Hooked on Heroes.
This is a wonderful organization for veterans, from veterans. The president's name is Ron Cato. He is a Vietnam Marine veteran. This guy does wonderful, wonderful things. If I take a moment, as Doc puts up the webpage, I'm going to take a moment and read the mission that Mr. Cato has, and I'll just be brief. So I'm going to read the mission. To take all veterans with or without disabilities, young and old, on a day of fishing at absolutely no cost to them. It is an opportunity for them to relax and have a stress-free day alongside other veterans. We strive to make them as comfortable as possible and to give them the best opportunity to catch fish and have fun. We plan to have two trips per year, absolutely 6 months apart. We supply the rod, the reels, the bait, the food, and the drinks. Wonderful organization, and this is what this show is all about. Vets helping vets, and I want to plug it again. Hooked on Heroes, Ron Cato, Vietnam Marine veteran. Let's get this popping, man. Let's get this out there. This is what it's all about.
Hell yeah.
Vets helping vets.
Thank you. Thank
That's
you,
the kind of shit that really, really makes my heart happy.
Yes.
Absolutely,
man. Veterans helping veterans.
My pleasure, Cato, to do this for you, brother.
Yeah, Semper Fi. That's amazing. So, yeah, definitely look that up if you guys are watching. And for the later broadcast that you're going to be watching later, definitely share this video. Pass the word along. Because, again, like I don't know if we said it earlier or not, we are a show that is trying to connect with other veterans. This is our way, our forum, our medium of reaching out to people and then having them reach out to us and giving us their ideas, just like this Hooked on Heroes on Hooks, or say it again, Hooked on Heroes.
Hooked on Heroes.
Hooked on Heroes. And, I mean, that's just a start. So, again, keep spreading the word. I can't stress it enough. We appreciate what you guys are doing so far for us right now, but definitely spread the word. Right now, I think we're at 46 or 47 subscribers. We need to get that up.
Let's get more. We need more people.
We need more people. We need to get the word out. And I'm getting choked up. So we definitely need your help. So definitely spread the word. Send them to our Facebook page. Send them to our YouTube page. But a wonderful story, Bobby. Man, that's excellent, man. Thank you again
for sharing that with us.
We'll leave a link. Both on our Facebook page and our YouTube page to that organization so that they can check it out. So again, thanks.
Awesome.
Fantastic. Well, I guess it gets up to me already. Really not too much. It's been a rough week, man. As far as not rough meaning, but just busy. It's been a busy week, which I love. When I stay busy, it just keeps me out of trouble. But quick little thing. My daughter, back in was Father's Day, had given me a gift card to Bass Pro Shop, and guess where I was near in an area today. I was in an area near where there was a Bass Pro Shop, and I had to kill some time, and you know, I had to get a filet knife because I don't have one. So this here is a Bass Pro Shop Grip Master 6-inch fillet knife. It has something couteau à fillet D15 comes, whatever that means. But I got it. It was $6.99. Nice. I think it was originally, you know, like $20, but if you guys haven't noticed, I'm a cheap ass.
Give us a review on that for next time?
I will give you guys a review as well as I bought a couple lures. Here's one right there. I think it's upside down.
Nice.
I got one of those. It actually goes like this. And when you do that, the fish jump on it like that. And just one more.
Like,
I love the.
It's like little kids. The they see something shiny.
They see it and then they want to bite it.
Nice.
And there's another one. Again, nice color. Nice. I'm going to be hitting the oceans, or not the oceans, the lakes. I'm in Chicago. There's no oceans in Chicago. That's Lake Michigan.
Lake Michigan. Right. It might as well be a fucking ocean.
Right. Yeah, might as well. But yeah, I'm going to.
That's cool stuff, man.
Going getting my kayak already. And so if you guys are out there, you'll see me. I'll have my my dive flag and my poles. So if you guys are out there in Lake Michigan, if you see me, give the old Spaniard a wave. So that's what's going on in my castle. So yeah, we got a great show lined up. We're going to send it right over to Doc because he's got what he has to say with the format. So take it away, Doc.
All right. So first things first, we're going to do a little game. We're going to try something new because that's what we do here. So I'm going to give you guys a scenario and you guys are going to try and sketch it out really quick.
Okay.
Right.
So, it's going to be fast. And I want you guys to kind of explain what you're doing as you're sketching and why you're sketching.
Drop the lure.
Here's what I want you to do.
All right, go for it.
I want you to sketch very quickly a three-legged horse.
Oh, snap.
And a person on that horse that is wearing disco shoes and sunglasses.
Three-legged horse.
Right. Three-legged horse.
You're putting me on the spot here.
A person with disco shoes and sunglasses.
I do not know how to draw for shit.
Okay.
I'm actually going to do this myself, too. So, all right. On your marks, get set. Go!
Go.
Person on it with disco shoes.
Three legs.
Three-legged.
Oh, I already fucked this up.
So are you guys doing like stick figure or are you actually trying to fucking draw in detail?
I'm actually trying to be creative here, man.
I'm trying to be creative here.
Don't mess with
me.
Okay. Good go.
All right, man. I got my artistic design going on.
I guess I
honestly don't
know
what disco shoes look like, so I'm just going to draw like some high heels or some shit.
Nah, I got my drawing down packed, man.
Jeez, this is gonna be kind of tough here. Yeah,
this is fucking great though. Hold on.
All right, I'm good to go. All
right, I got mine. Are you guys good? Let's do it.
All right, shit. This is
What do you guys got? Spaniard, go for it.
Go first. All right, I don't know if you could see that there.
Holy cow, similar to mine.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I don't know. I panicked. I really panicked.
So the leg is going to nowhere on that. I'm just gonna throw that out there. There's a leg that's there, but it's not attached to anything.
That was that was a hand me down horse. That was damn, I thought it was good. Let's see what you got. Okay.
Oh, you wanna see mine? All right.
Yeah, let's see yours. I'll be last.
I did stick figure. This is what I got.
Oh, that's cheating.
Oh, come on.
That's,
a little
I
more
call
artistic
bullshit
ingenuity, guys.
Oh. Come on. All right, I'm disqualified.
We're not drawing dicks there, Tate. We're drawing horse. Well, I was going to draw a dick, but No, it does kind of look like a deck. I don't know.
Picasso here, dude. Mine's. You see, I got the afro shit. Because it's the disco shoe. You got the afro going on.
Yeah,
you got
yeah.
The black, okay. Oh, look at that.
The black church shoes.
Wow, man.
That's the set, man. There you go. That's artistic design right there.
That's incredible.
That is pretty incredible. That's where almost a mirror image similar, of that just about.
Except my guy got a fro.
Holy shit. That's crazy, man. That is crazy. So, all right, Doc. So what does that mean?
Yeah. What are you talking about? Like, is this like a Rorschach test or something?
Yeah. Well, yeah, a TAT, isn't that what this was? I thought this was like an assessment, a behavioral assessment. Like, I'm waiting for you to say that, yeah, you're addicted to dicks because you draw my third leg looks like a dick.
All right. You're the psychology.
In a Freudian sense, I would say that both of are, you have penis envy. So you guys are scared of your dad's penis.
Scared.
Oh, okay.
You want to be your dad, so you that way. Yeah, that. Yeah.
I am not. Yeah. I am not the scared of nothing, man. I'm not scared of nothing.
Not the devil dog, bro.
No, no, man.
So for the people out there, draw us a three-legged horse.
So that's the next.
You viewers. You do it.
There we go. Yes. Submit your drawing. A picture of your drawing of the exact same thing, Doc. Tell them what they're supposed to be drawing. And
they're supposed to be drawing.
The best picture will win a prize.
Oh, yeah, that's a good. Yeah, that's perfect.
That T-shirt that's held back in customs.
They will win a lure. Yeah.
Everything is held up in customs. So don't accept it within the first year.
The best picture will win a lipless crankbait sponsored or brought to you by Bass Pro Shops. It's a tourney special, finely detailed finish, stainless steel, 3DI. So. That's the prize. Best picture.
So what's going on? We got any comments, Doc?
Oh, not really.
Well, yeah, we got a bunch.
Kind of. Back to the drawing board by Steve.
I'm looking at the wrong website.
Tate Villarreal? Bunch of eggplant?
Yeah, he's a Marine. Yes.
I'm not really sure what he means by bunch of eggplant, but I'm sure it's probably phallic in nature.
And then Bobby, check your email.
I don't know if you can see it because Steve, our number one Coke fan, drew a little drawing. I'm trying to put it on my phone.
Oh, he did it?
Yeah, he drew a drawing. Awesome.
I can't see shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to post it.
Hey, isn't he your neighbor? Tell him to bring over a coffee really quick.
Yeah. But, hey, he's getting involved, man.
That's perfect. It. I like it. Getting involved. See, there's the egg. So what do eggplants? I guess I'm not an emoji follower. Help me out here. What does eggplant mean? What is the eggplant emoji supposed to mean? Vegetarian?
I think it means dick, but I'm not really sure, and I'm not quite sure what context to use it in as well. I only use really two emojis. Okay, well, four. I use like the one with the crying face and laughing the one where you're like rolling on the floor laughing and
the
ones where I send my wife is the ones with the hard eyes and then the
I send this to my wife that's typical, I'm gonna start
sending that to mine.
Yeah, it works. Oh, okay, so Tate says eggplant equals dicks. Wow, that's profound.
Oh okay I didn't know that.
The more you know.
I guess so that's a public service announcement from Tate Villarreal. And speaking of which, he is a Marine. So we need to have him on. Semper Fi, brother. We need to have you on as one of our next guests because I'm sure you got some special stories to tell us, some of the shit you encounter on a daily basis. So yeah, there it is. There's the hole right there. I love it.
Oh, got it. Yeah.
Hey. Great.
Speaking, did you guys catch my latest episode of Intrusive Thoughts?
Oh, awesome, bro. You got a good tolerance for pain, brother.
Sounds very painful.
It you know what? The funny thing is, we've been doing this for years, right? So just to kind of give you a little backstory, if you guys, I don't know, I'm kind of afraid to give it away. So if you haven't seen my latest episode of Intrusive Thoughts, go to it right now. I'll save it. You got seven to nine minutes. I forgot. Check it out. Come back. Let me know when you've seen it. And then I'll tell you the backstory behind it. But really that was the trophy wife's idea. That was all her idea.
She just likes causing you pain.
I think so. Yeah. I think so.
What is that? Is that like sadism? Is that what it is?
I don't know what it is. Sadism. Yeah, I think she just likes to fucking hurt me. That's what it is.
She was going to town, man.
Because even when we watched it afterwards, she was like, "Oh man, I could have said this or I could have said that." She had all these comebacks. I'm like, "Sorry, man, you were in the zone, man."
She was.
I like how she ripped off a strip and then laughed about it. That was my favorite part.
She is sadistic. She's a sadistic woman, man. But you gotta love her. Gotta love her. Holy shit. Hey, but the other thing too is not only is she doing a good job for me, but she's doing a good job. Well, she's doing it for you guys because you don't want to see that shit. You know, you don't want to. It wouldn't look appealing. You know, I mean, I got a reputation to uphold, so I gotta have a smooth back. You know, gotta have the velvet voice, smooth back. That's the deal. Ogre.
So not like a silverback.
Not a silverback. That's a different guy. That's one of my brothers on the Atlanta Misfits. He's we'll probably hopefully have him on here shortly too. He's another Marine, another Devil Dog. Has some good stories to tell too. So we've got a question here that says, "Where is Ogre?" From what I was told, it was a family event or something that happened that was family related. And I said, no worries. Show will go on. We're going to miss him. But yeah, he will be back on Monday. Now, I don't think it's the 50 Shades convention, but I don't know. I'll let him. He's out with his hoes. Yeah, I don't know what it is. But
he's got to keep track, man.
He will tell us on Monday, definitely on Monday. But that's good little instruction there. So what else is going on in Doc's mind?
Oh, yeah, what's going on?
I don't think you guys actually want to be there. I mean, it's quite a complicated space. But
okay.
I've been thinking about it, and I actually did a little bit of research on it. But you guys know, like, when you give – or when a woman gives birth, not you because you guys are men – You guys are giving birth. That's fucking weird.
We have penises.
Yeah.
Men have penises. Girls have vaginas.
That's right. That's really good. They teach that in astronomy class. Is it astronomy or astrology? What the hell do you got?
Yeah.
Teach that. Yeah.
They have to. I mean.
Good for you.
No way about. Yeah. Anyways. When a woman gives birth, she has this extra organ that's called the placenta.
Right.
And what? Do you guys do? You guys have your wives have had children, correct?
Yes.
Yes.
What did your wives do with their placenta? Was it a hospital birth and they just took it away and kind of got rid of it?
Placenta. You said placenta. That's right. I got it right here. I got it in this drawer right over here, man. No. I don't know. They took it away, I guess.
Oh, okay. Well, because there's actually. A huge, like, I wouldn't say huge, but there's a cult following saying that you should eat your placenta.
Oh, I heard that. Oh, my God. Yeah, I heard that.
To replenish, like, your nutrients, vitamins, and other stuff. But
I heard that, man.
Replenish.
But they actually have a service that you can send your placenta to, and they will, yeah, they will put your placenta, like, cut it down, or I don't know how they do it exactly, but... They will put it in pill form for the women to take as a fucking pill. Man.
Oh my God.
Right?
Oh man.
That's sick, man.
So my question is, is that considered cannibalism?
Yes.
What do you guys think?
Oh, without a doubt.
I would say yes.
To the seven people watching, is that cannibalism? Is eating
that's
the
part
placenta.
Of your body, man. What the hell? What are we, Jeffrey Dahmer here?
Well, I mean, the only reason why it would be considered cannibalism is that it's because it's from the same species.
Oh, my God. I gotta take a swing. Oh, God.
Man, you must be really fucking bored, man. Katie, holy you need to come home, man. You need to take care of this guy. He's fucking talking about eating placentas. What's next?
My other question is, is it cannibalism to consume sperm?
Whoa! Oh, I'm getting old.
Ah, man, come on. Why do you gotta? You always, Ooh. you always, Why do you gotta go down that road?
You gotta realize I gotta go upstairs to Mrs. Double Dog after this, and she's gonna question me about all this stuff that we're talking about.
Oh man! So we have a comm here. Might want to go ahead and see that.
All right, read that comment.
What if you get someone else's placenta by mistake? Whoa!
With a sick face. Wow. Now that.
Yeah.
Oh. Well,
possibility.
So what you're saying is
I already want to vomit.
You go back. You go to the hospital that you're at, and you say, "Can I have a to go, like a to go container and
a doggy bag?"
What's a doggy bag? Wow.
Oh
man.
Lord.
No, no, no. Come on. I don't think, is that even ethical? Can they even do that? Like, are there any medical doc? Better yet, are there any OBGYNs out there, or any nurse, what do you call them? Nurse mothers, home mothers. No, what do you call them? Nursemaids?
Midwives.
There you go. Nursemaids. That's something else. Yeah. If anybody that is out there, man, chime in, let us know, or, cause that's a good thing. But, I would say, going back to the second question you had asked about the, I'm going to have to think on that one.
I'm going to flat out say no.
Because there's nothing to it. There's no substance.
Okay.
But really, there's no.
So your spunk is not considered like flesh, is what you're saying?
No, it's not. It's not flesh.
Nah.
It's like eating boogers. Is eating your boogers. Is that fucking cannibalism? Holy shit. How the fuck do we get on this shit, man?
Hey, this is what we do on the show, man.
Oh, man.
That's what we do, man.
Oof. But yeah. But good point, though. It is a good point. Yeah. Eating boogers is not cannibal.
They got some great education up in there, man.
Okay. Yeah,
that's Northern Illinois for you.
Huskies, go Huskies.
Finest, baby.
Yeah. Good Huskies.
Tip of the iceberg. Oh,
that's right.
Oh, wait. No. Tip of the spear.
God, that you didn't even awesome, know your own man. Damn school's alma mater chant or cheer with tip of the iceberg.
I don't even know that we have one, to be honest. I haven't heard about it.
How long you been going to this school, university?
Yeah, like 2 years.
God damn. Yeah.
Wow.
What else you got? Let's change the topic now, because now I had vaginitis for dinner.
I got to focus again, man.
Yeah, yeah, we got to get off of this penis and vagina shit. So let's go to Amazon Alexa. You guys have seen the stories about that, right? Is it really a she? Because it's not. It's really. It's not a person. So
the name is Alexa.
Yeah, the name.
Anything
is Alexa.
Ends in A is usually a female. You know, like if she was Latina, she would definitely be female, because Alexa.
There she is, right here, my Latina.
Oh, that's true.
Man, there it is.
I love you, Amazon.
So
it's my girl, man.
He's been reprogrammed.
people have been saying
they're watching
that she's
you, Bobby.
Like,
man, they're watching you.
In the middle of the night.
Yeah, like a
and
witch.
Not like any laugh, a diabolical laugh.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I mean,
that's wicked.
I have an Alexa here, or an Amazon Echo Dot thing. But, man, if I happened to wake up in the middle of the night and heard that shit, I'd be clearing my house with my freaking weapon.
Yo, that would freak me out, man. No, I'd be out in my drawers. I'd run right out.
Another comment came in from Tate. It's a shim. Am I reading that right? What is a shim mean? Again, I don't go out much. I'm not on the interweb a lot, and I'm kind of behind a learning curve when it comes to or is that supposed to be sham? Maybe it's a typo. I don't know. Let us know, because no shim.
Well, I know what a shim is. That's what you put into like the door frames and window frames to make them level.
Right, to make it shim it.
Yeah,
shimmy.
Yeah,
a door shim. You know what I'm talking about.
Oh, she-him. A she-him.
Oh.
I get it.
See, yes.
There it is.
Been hitting the head several times. I'm a little slow.
Yeah, I didn't catch that either, man.
Yeah. She-him.
All right. She-him.
Are there some around here? Is that what were we talking about that brought up? What was that? She, him. Damn, I can't even remember. I'm going to try that shot on here now.
If we got any she, hims on the air, leave a comment.
Let us know.
Welcome aboard, man. Shim,
you know, yeah, welcome aboard.
So what's up with Steve trying breast milk?
Oh, God. Wait, what? Yeah, what?
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 That's Steve.
Okay, that's our cope serious guy. Question. Serious, honest to God question here. When your wives were pregnant, have you tried it?
Breast milk?
Yes, please tell
Hell
me.
Hell no.
Because, no. Well, okay. I'm just going to go on the record here and say that when my wife's pregnant, I'm probably going to try it. Why not? Okay. I got to make sure it's safe for my kid.
That is true. Because like I said, you're I guess, yeah, it could be poison, right? Poison milk. So you don't know what's coming out from those things. Well, it's like that, Dave Chappelle, that he's like, Teddy's giving out sour milk. You got to test that shit out first, right? Oh, and Steve said he was dared. Yeah, all right.
Steve. Steve got a little freakiness in him, man.
Yeah, that's right. Hey, that's okay,
wait.
It's all
I
good,
need to
Steve.
Throw a disclaimer out here. I was dared to do it too.
Okay, all right. It all starts with a dare. That's all it takes.
That's it. That's
it. All starts with a hey, man.
Hey, if it's a dare, it's okay.
That's all right.
It's okay.
Do it. Yeah, then do it.
That's great.
I don't think
man.
That's wrong. Now, is that cannibalism?
Well, man, I would say no because you're not technically eating flesh, though. Why are we back on this subject?
We're back on that again. I don't know.
Yeah, let's get. I mean, what's wrong with us today, man?
What's next? What's next on the docket there, Doc?
Let's get something. There we go.
Yeah.
All right. So
let's get some positive stuff going on.
Happiness.
Man, okay, you said positive, but it's actually kind of a negative because.
Go for it.
Toys R Us is declaring bankruptcy.
I heard.
But how sad is that? I used to love going there.
The smell, just walking in the door, that smelled good.
It was like a castle of toys everywhere.
Yeah, damn it, man. All these things are, man, everything I love is going away, man.
I know, man.
It's a shame, man.
I don't want to bring this down, but...
It's true though.
No online type of shit. Like they're not gonna have like a Toys R Us online.
I mean, Amazon is beating everyone right now. I mean, it's hard to compete with them.
Amazon and eBay are taking over. You are right, Steve. I wish I would have bought stock when the timing was right, because we would have interns right now. You know,
yeah,
it would be mayhem
and
right now.
Steve will have his shirt.
Steve would have his shirt.
Goddamn shipping department.
Mm. Yeah. You know,
we're working on it, cool. Steve. We're working on it, man.
We got this. We got this. But yeah, I don't want to grow up, man.
It was sad to hear about that.
This is kind of like how I felt when malls were going away. Oh, like, I mean, we kind of knew it was coming, but we were still kind of shocked.
Yeah.
Man.
Well, there's I forgot what show it was. I think it's on Viceland. If anybody's not familiar with it, it's a network and they have a show called Abandoned. And this guy visits these old places. And one of them was the malls, like all these malls all around the world here. Well, especially the U.S. It's creepy, man. It's sad because, I mean, these were at one time flourishing and now it's just empty, man. It is kind of sad, but hey, man. Shit happens, man. The other thing I don't understand is people are still building. They keep building. Like, fuck, man. Like, I could see now my neighbors that are a mile away, whereas I couldn't see them before.
Wow.
You know, they keep knocking down trees, adding a subdivision, knocking down trees, another subdivision.
Yeah. All the way in the South Bronx. Everything's being built in the South Bronx in my neck of the woods where I work at. I'm like, that's all we need. More buildings, really? And then more problems, man.
More problems.
I mean, at some point, there's going to be our population on the earth is going to be unsustainable. So, I mean, we're going to need to figure out some shit here quick.
It's going to turn into water world, a real life water world. Because, I mean, we're flooding. I mean, there's not enough land to absorb the water, and the water's not getting to the oceans fast enough. So, there's something definitely going on here that, you know, I'm sure people, the scientists, are they're probably saying, hey, we told you, motherfuckers.
Al Gore, man. Al Gore said it. Al Gore said it.
Mm-hmm. Al Gore, what is he? What is he? What is he doing now?
It's about global warming and all that crap, you know.
Well, he's the one that brought it up.
Yeah.
What is he doing now? Is he just living off his riches and retirement? Like, what the fuck is he doing? I've never heard about him recently.
I think he works at Staples.
Yeah.
Something like that.
You know, I think I might have seen him there.
Yeah. He works in the paper department.
We need our ogres and his research department to look that up.
Oh, I know. Yeah. See, like today in history.
Fact checker.
Today in history. That's what we're missing today. Yeah, I know. See, I was really tied up today. Literally tied up. I didn't have enough time to do my research. So, I'm leaving it all up to Doc today. So he's our fact checker. He is our today in history.
It's all on me.
It's all on Doc. So if you guys don't like the show tonight, blame it on Doc, because this was his fucking deal tonight. I told him, this is your show.
I don't give a shit if you don't like it.
There he is, right there, Doc.
My Alexa says she can help me with this. What the hell?
Ooh, you spank
Alexa? She's not in the blue, says, I can help you with that.
Ooh, you spank Alexa.
I mean, I don't know where. She's talking to me. Oh, my God. You're
dirty, man. You are dirty. Fucking body. Spanking Alexa. Yeah.
So, I don't know if you guys are fans, but Supernatural is a great show, and they're doing an animated episode next week. I guess this could be considered a little plug for them, but they're kind of modeling the Scooby-Doo animation.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I heard about that. Yeah.
Scooby-Doo is great,
man. I'm actually pretty excited about it, because I'm a pretty big Supernatural fan. I've been watching them since the
I like Super season. Snatch. Supernatural. That's my favorite. So that's my favorite.
That, is that like a pornographic? Can I find that on YouPorn? Or...
you probably could. Look up Super Snatch. You might see me in it. I don't know. Or maybe not. Maybe no. Don't look up Super Snatch.
You're in porn?
I'm in porn. Yes.
There we go. That don't surprise me, man.
It is.
Don't surprise me.
Halfway curious. Halfway kind of skeptical.
Look him up. Duke Fillmore.
That's it. That's your stage name, bro.
Speaking of Devil Dog, what would your porn stage name be?
Oh, man. Let's give it some thought. Because I want Mr. Double Dog to be impressed. That way we can get at it later on.
Got you.
At it.
All right, Mr. Double Dog, focus.
It's going to be. Yours?
Is it gonna be Double Dick? I don't know.
Oh wow, that's not bad, but no.
Double Dick. That sounds kind of satanic.
Yeah.
Double Dick.
You're kind of right, but I mean, if you were around a group of Marines, they would totally agree that was awesome.
Yeah, badass, bad fucking day. Let's get a tattoo, man. Hoorah! Let's get a tattoo, man. Fuck it up. Let's fuck this up, man. real quick, off topic, Doc, you're probably not going to understand this, but Bobby, I can't remember his first name, but you remember this dude. He was albino. He was my roommate for a little bit, but I don't remember his first name, but his last name was LaDouche. And remember that? It was LaTouche or LaDouche. He was French.
LaTouche.
LaTouche, right? He was like LaTouche. French or like Cajun, but he was like brighter than white, man. He was. You could see through him. That's how like he was like transparent.
I remember he
had to wear camouflage because otherwise you wouldn't see him. But man, that it was hilarious, man. LaTouche. And I remember you would see him and you would just scream his name and scare the shit out of LaTouche. And he would turn whiter. He would turn whiter than what he was, man. He was like a chameleon. Yeah. Disappear after that. I can't remember his first name.
I remember him, man. I remember him.
Yeah.
Those are good old days, man.
Good old days. So yeah, but sorry, it was just I don't know what reminded me of that, but LaTouche. Good old fucking LaTouche. All right, Doc, what's next on Doc's world?
Yeah, I can't think of a porn name. Sorry, I can't think of one.
No porn name.
Yeah, no,
I can't think of one.
Unacceptable. I'm not gonna move on until you think
for
of
next
one.
Show.
I'm gonna say, here we go. The Bronx Baller.
Oh,
that's great. Baller. Yeah,
Bronx Baller.
Yeah.
That is perfect.
Okay. It just came up to my head, man.
Speaking Spaniard. Of the Bronx, yeah.
What is yours?
Oh, yeah. I already told you. Duke Fillmore. That's my name.
Really?
Duke Fillmore, yes.
Duke Fillmore.
Duke was the name of my first dog, and I lived on Fillmore Street.
Wow.
Fillmore. Oh, so you're doing one of those.
Yeah, that is. That's it's simple, and it's me.
I feel like mine is quite obvious because my last name is perfect for this.
It is.
It can't get any better than Sweetwood.
Sweetwood, yeah.
Oh,
that's it.
Oh, that's true.
So there you go. I don't think that's people knew good. Your last name. Yeah, I think people now will know your last name is Sweetwood.
Surprise.
That's pretty good, man.
Surprise. That's why he's always happy. You always see Doc smiling.
That's pretty good, man.
That is good. It's good. I'm going to need a refill. I don't know if I should yell for Trophy Wife or text her.
Do it. Do it.
Yell?
Yeah.
All right,
She's not going to respond,
do it,
man.
Come on, do it.
Hey, Trophy Wife!
Now, let's see how long it's going to take her to come down and give you a drink.
I hope she comes in like, what the fuck?
And slaps you upside the head, man. What the hell you want?
Oh man. I couldn't even. Nope.
I'm trying to listen for footsteps.
Yo, honey. Can you help hook me up with a drink? I'll tip you.
Huh?
Oh man.
With the tip of the dick.
Why would you text? Why would you yell like that? You scared the hell.
I scared you. Sorry. Cause I can't text.
She's pissed. You pissed her off now, man. I said, come. I leave Mrs. Double Dog alone. I leave her alone.
Way to go, Doc. You fucking got me in trouble.
Hey, man. It's all your fault, what? Doc. You dared him.
My fault. Come on.
Yeah, watch. She's gonna throw.
You were egging him on just as much as I was.
Yeah, you were, Bobby. You definitely
that was sweet,
were.
Man.
We'll see.
I enjoyed
Meatloaf,
that.
Yeah, Bob Meatloaf. Fucking Katie, that was beautiful. Yeah, she's
my better half right there, by the way.
She's gonna piss in it. Watch. She's gonna.
Yeah, I want you to drink that shit too, man.
I'll drink. I went to the Driftwood in Jacksonville, North Carolina, man. I can drink anything.
So have I, man.
Like, yeah,
that was
dude.
Back in the day.
We could drink anything. Like a military special, set it up. We'll drink it. I don't care. Set it up.
We just got a long ass comment from our Coke dealer.
Uh-oh. Oh, read it.
Go ahead. Read it, Doc.
It says, license revoked. The city of Miami Beach has revoked the business license of the nightclub where a frightened horse was brought onto the dance floor.
Dang it.
Wow.
What?
Steve, the Coke guy.
Why is there a horse on a dance floor? That's what I want to know.
Hey, he got his drink. Way to go, Trophy Wife.
It worked. Yeah.
Way to go.
Here's the Good Trophy job. Wife.
Steve, man, I don't know what a horse is doing on the dance floor or what's going on in Miami, man, but what the hell?
Yeah.
Oh,
dance
my
floor.
God.
What dance? Wait, this is Miami. Damn, man. I went to Miami once, and I got to tell you, I need to go back. Miami, oh, shit.
Never
man,
been there.
They know how to party, man. I don't know.
Yeah?
I'm telling you what, man. You remember my boy Block, right? You remember Block? I don't know if you know him, but he was from Fort Lauderdale, and I went to go visit. Man, Miami.
Yep.
Ooh, man, saborosa. Wow. Man. It is hot. I'm talking it's hot.
Wow.
Doc. You would just blow up in flames, man. It's just too hot for you. I don't think you could handle Miami because it's just fuego, man. It's beautiful. But yeah,
go crazy for Doc, his beard.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Speaking of Miami, I am on spring break this week.
Hey.
Well, all right, man.
Spring break, baby.
You know where
so
I'm
what
going?
Are you doing?
Yes.
Donde vas?
DeKalb.
That means where are you going?
Okay. Really, you got on the first guess. I was hoping you were going to say, like, I don't
are
know.
Are you going to
Daytona Beach or Cancun or something? But no, I mean, yeah.
Well, don't go to Mexico, man. They're killing, they're blowing up people in Mexico. You don't want to go
You
down
might
there.
Not come back either.
I'm staying here in DeKalb.
Just stay.
If you go to Mexico, you're going to be detained.
Yeah, don't go on a ferry because they're blowing up ferries. Don't stay where you're at, people. Just don't go anywhere.
Yeah,
cruises,
man,
I don't know if they're even safe. You know, you're gonna get the shit. You're gonna have diarrhea for the whole entire time when you're on a cruise.
I don't mess with that, man.
It's a It's a crapshoot. Get it? It's a crapshoot. You're going to go on a boat and you're going to shit your pants because it's nothing but salmonella, I guess, from what everybody said. But I could be wrong. I know the trophy wife will not set foot on a fucking cruise ship.
Speaking of crapshoot, I tried to make some homemade refried beans this week. And they turned out completely fucking terrible.
How can you fuck up refried beans?
Yeah, well, how did you prepare it, man?
I slow cooked them all day. I grilled up I sauteed some onions and garlic. I put it in there and slow cooked the beans all day. Then mashed them up and added some other herbs and spices, but still turned out like shit. But I have a problem with cleaning my dishes as soon as I'm done with them. So I left the slow cooker on the counter for like 4 days. The extra juices from the beans were like leached out when it was cooking. So there was like a sludge in there, and it kind of smelled like brown gravy, which is, you would think, is like, that's nice, but
not bad.
Yeah, but the appearance looked like some goddamn green apple splatters. It was fucking disgusting looking.
You're gross, man. That's all there is to it. You're just a gross ass fucking.
Someone took a shit in my slow cooker. Man. It was fucking gross.
So did you throw the whole cooker away?
No, I bleached it.
Oh, man, so I would have thrown it out.
Yeah. Oh, you got to.
I just thought of a new idea. This, I don't know if you've been watching Tate. I don't know if you're not a friend of Tate Villarreal on Facebook. He does a lot of pictures of the food that he eats. And I just had an idea because you were talking about refried beans. But Tate, I'm going to throw this out there for you if you're still watching. How would you like to do to be one of our on-the-site food critics that you check in with us every once in a while and give us your review on some of the food you've eaten? Because I've seen some of the pictures. And if you guys haven't known, you check him out on Facebook. He takes pictures of the food that he goes. He goes to restaurants and he takes pictures. I don't want to give away what he does, but his job, he is in law enforcement.
Awesome, man.
He's always out and about, and he's always taking pictures of some of his food, and some of that shit looks fantastic. I would love to hear what you have to say about that. So it's out there. Think about it. Get back to me. IM me. Something could be a future segment on the show.
That'd be cool.
So we'll check that out. So it's something to think about. See, I'm always fucking thinking, man. Pop in my head.
I'll make shit for you, and you tell us how it tastes. If it tastes like
garbage, there you go.
Tell me. There you go. That's a good one.
There you go.
What do you think? He's a landscaper.
Landscaper. All right, nice. Man.
So I got a joke That'll for work. You guys.
All right, we got a joke. Joke from the doc.
Speaking of food.
Back show. Yes.
All right. What does a pizza man and a gynecologist have in common?
Pizza man and gynecologist. Oh, geez. Pizza man and gynecologist.
I'm drawing a blank.
Well, you know what? They both get to smell it, but they can't eat it.
I have my drums are next door in the next room.
Well, all right.
Yeah, I got to get my drums.
Oh, I actually have a drum set. I'll bring them out, but it's not going to happen.
Save it for next show. So Steve says, my bro takes pics of the food he be eating. Bobby all the seen time. In action. Yeah?
All the and time.
I don't know. I mean, it's a cool
thing. Speaking of
cool
your brother, thing. Where is he? Your brother should be logged in. Where is he? Where's Massimo?
That's his name, Massimo?
His brother's name is Massimo. Massimo.
Wow,
Massimo.
That's a cool name.
I feel like this is something
man.
That we should be chanting cool. in the Coliseum.
In a Coliseum. Yeah. Well, let's get Steve and him to fight to the finish.
Yeah,
man.
Let's go for it. In my backyard.
Like that shit. Yeah, in
right
the backyard.
In my backyard.
Yeah, in the backyard.
With spears and shit.
Like Thunderdome. No, there'll be weapons like scattered in the yard. You gotta run. You gotta find the weapons. Man, I like that, dude. That'll be a fundraiser idea. American
Here we
Legion.
Go, Steve. Steven Massimo. Fight
you're on
the
you're on the billet, man. You're on the billet. We're gonna write it down.
There
main
we go.
Event.
There the we winner go. Gets a T-shirt.
There you go.
Whenever we get it. Whenever shipping brings that shit to us.
Shipping. It's in Colombia, man. You know, the Colombians, you know, they're working this out. They're helping us out, man. So don't say that.
It's coming, man. It's coming.
So, Steve Massimo, the fight is on, baby. My backyard. Is on. Coming okay. at this summer, baby.
Yeah, Roman times. That's it. That's so what it, else? Baby. We got a few minutes left. So what else do you got for us, Doc?
All right. The last thing I have on my little sheet of information is our sexual position of the day.
Yeah, you gotta lay it on us, brother. Better intro. You got a better intro. We'll get there.
Yeah, I'll work on it.
Yeah, that's good. So I'm excited because I mean these positions are like it's exciting to see.
Have you tried any of them?
No comment.
Well, not fair enough. I'll take no comment. That's okay.
I'm not that agile. And Mr. Double Dog doesn't really do that shit.
If you're not agile, okay. So today
stretch.
Is gonna be
I do a lot of stretching first. I prepare. I warm up.
Oh, that's fair. A lot of yoga, like the warrior pose.
Oh my God, I did some yoga this morning. See, I do yoga. I kind of use a guide on YouTube. So, yeah, that's all I gotta say. That's why I do yoga. I love it.
Yoga's no joke. Don't let it fool you. Mm-hmm. But anyways. Back to the sexual position of the day. So
lay it on us.
Today I have something that everyone can do.
All right, let's go.
Probably. Maybe. We'll see. Let me go ahead and get this fired up here. All right, here we go. You guys see it?
Oh, okay.
Okay.
So
don't tell us the name. Wait. Don't tell us the name. Don't tell us the name. Let me see if I can guess. I don't know, Bobby, any ideas?
The row your boat.
The row boat. Yeah. Wait. I was going to say sunset breeze.
No, that's not close. Yeah, that's way off. But what it is rock the cradle.
Oh, I was kind of close.
Yeah, you were.
You were saying rowing.
The concept, man.
Kind of, yeah. But here's how it goes. The man leans back while the lovers are facing each other. Okay. She mounts him by sitting on his lap, placing her feet under his shoulders. And then they rock back and forth while holding each other's arms for support.
Oh. You go like little rock. Well,
yeah, exactly.
You go back. Yeah, Tate says that's otherwise. Well, that's the sit on my dick.
Okay, I can understand where you're coming
from. She's
not
really sitting on it though. She's not sitting on it.
If you look at the picture, it's a little bit different.
You guys are killing me, man.
So wait a second. So she's gonna have to guide you in a little. Otherwise,
yeah, she's basically doing all the work here.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
All right. So Steve says, hold on to the train.
Hold on to the train.
Well, what from what mean? I know of a train, this is not anywhere close to a train.
Yeah. He's got a big imagination.
One guy after another.
He's a freak, man. That's Steve. Your neighbor, man.
I'm telling you, man.
I mean, freaking it's all that coke that he's doing. What's going on?
Well, I can't wait to come visit you again, Bobby, because I'm going to hang out at Steve's house.
We'll go hang out with Steve, man.
Is there a lot of leather stuff and dungeon-like shit in his basement that we should know about?
Oh, man, that's awesome, man. Well, thank you for that wonderful diagram, Doc.
Oh, yeah.
I like it.
So that's doable.
What was
you
that called?
Yeah. Get back on that one.
What was that called again? Give us the name again. Rocking the cradle. All right, I got it.
I think the ogre man could do that as well.
I think he
could
do that.
It's good for big people. Yeah,
it's possible.
It's good for big people. We'll see. We'll have to have him chime in. Let us know.
Works. Well, let us know if your hoes can do that.
Yeah.
Oh man.
Oh, that's awesome.
So what are you guys doing this weekend? It's gonna be again, we're March. You're in spring break, Doc. How, you know, the weather is lightening up yet in, on the East Coast yet, Bobby?
Yeah, it's getting better, and spring break, like the doc. My Ashley is coming home tomorrow.
Nice.
Very for spring nice. Break. So she's coming That's home awesome, tomorrow. Man. We're excited. And yeah. then my little one, she'll be home the following weekend.
Fantastic.
So here's Man, my she... thing for you, Devil Dog. Interview your daughter.
You got Ooh, it.
Yeah, that would be it. Cool. Yeah. Yeah, that's it. That's cool, man. I can't. Yeah, that's. I'm so happy for her.
I'll bring Ashley over, man.
How was her birthday? Did you guys do anything? You gonna do something special for her this weekend?
Well, we're gonna try to do something for her because being that she was away in D.C., we really couldn't do much. Yeah. But we always have fun when she's here. We'll take her out to dinner, and we'll have a lot of fun with Ashley. She's wonderful, but Ashley's like straight up school, work. So you know, maybe we'll take her out to dinner and make her have some fun. And that's just Ashley, you know.
What is she like?
She's seafood. She's seafood. She, yeah, she's lobster. Not a big, you know. So whatever her and Mr. Devil Dog.
Is there any good seafood restaurants in the Bronx?
We got City Island, brother. City Island. Everything. City Island.
I want to go to New York again, man. I want to spend at least five days. It's like I get this image, you know. You hear people from the, you know, the Bronx. I'm from the Bronx. I'm from the Bronx, and then you got people say Brooklyn, man. I'm from Brooklyn. You know, they got I want to go to all the different boroughs of the town, you know, the cities, and just feel it, the food. I want to spend like five days.
Down, man.
What do you think, Doc? You in? We'll take a road trip.
If you're going, I'm going with you.
Come on down, like bro.
If you're going to Pennsylvania, I mean, I'll fly out to Pennsylvania, and we'll drive out to New York. I want
to
do
That's it. Man. We'd love to have you here, brother.
Right.
There is
vegan. Yeah, Mrs. Oh, yes, Double Dog.
Mrs. Double Dog is vegan, so lay off the vegan jokes, all right?
Well, she said it. She made a comment. She said vegan. So wherever you guys go, it's she said it.
All right, so we'll go vegan for Mrs. Double Dog, and me and Ashley will get whatever it is we get.
Okay, so when it comes to fish, I'm not going to eat any fish. I fucking hate it. It's fucking disgusting.
I don't
eat it. Anything that comes from water, I don't eat it.
I don't like the smell.
If it's a cow, what's wrong with eating the shit out of it.
Oh, I don't eat lobster, none of that crap, man.
Oh, man. That
shit looks freaky.
I know, right? I am so glad you are with me, and there are more people like me.
I don't like shrimp, lobster, crab.
Scallops? You don't like scallops?
I don't either. No!
You guys are wrong. You guys are just all kinds of wrong. You guys are Marines and Navy. You're surrounded by seafood.
No thank you, man. No thanks.
Bro. I wasn't with the Navy. I mean, I was with the Marines the whole time.
Yeah, but it's ocean water related.
We're surrounded.
Everywhere we go, we're surrounded by water, man. I was always
the closest I've been to being on the ocean was when I visited one of my friend's ships in the port of San Diego, and I wasn't even a part of the ship. I just visited.
Wow.
What is Antonio's about?
Antonio's is a great restaurant that Steve and Massimo. They take me, like, on Mondays, we go, we have a good time at the family-type atmosphere. As Italians, I'm the only brown guy there, you know? But it's a great place, man. Great Italian food. And Antonio's. Then. That's Antonio's. And, yeah, Steve, I may take you up on that.
Fucking hey, I love New York. I got to go to New York again, man. We got to go to New York.
Look it down Bronx, baby.
Fucking hey, let's do it, Doc. I'm telling you. I'm gonna book us a flight.
Whatever your game.
I'm gonna put it on the BlackSheep Bravo account.
There you go.
Let's do it. Expense that shit.
We'll expense it.
Put that shit on the expense account, man.
Right. Well, it's been an hour.
All right.
Man, that time flies when you're having fun. That's
just, it. That's what we're here for. Entertain our veterans, man.
That was a fast hour.
That was. Here's another final toast to all of our veterans. Let me try that again. Here's to all of our veterans, both deployed and abroad and at home. Welcome home. Here's to you.
God bless you. Welcome home. Get home safe.
Hell yeah. So that brings us to an end to another Friday night of the BlackSheep Bravo Roundtable. Thank you all for watching. Well, before we go, we're going to do one final thought around the table. We're going to start off with Doc first. Doc, final thoughts.
Oh, man, what a great night it's been. Seriously, yeah. This has been a lot of fun. Yeah. And I really hope we're continuing this into the future. I mean, I'm having a lot of fun here.
Absolutely.
So, more and more.
But a little bit more of a profound kind of moment, I guess. Learn your friends' names.
Yeah.
Come on, people.
That's important.
Like, what is wrong with you?
No, yeah. Ask their names first.
Yes.
But you know what? That's your fault. Now it's going on too long.
It is.
You better know. Hey, dude. How do you spell your first name?
Hey, right. Why don't you be like Brian or something like that? He's like Brian.
Oh, well, there's a couple of ways to sign. You know, there's Bry, there's Brine.
Oh, okay.
Bry is usually common. So, yeah.
That's fair. But then he's going to be like, what are you going to send me? A goddamn letter through the mail? I'm going to be like, yes. No, I just needed to know your name.
I was going to send you a gift card to Bass Pro Shop or Cabela's or something. Red Lobster. Yeah. Well, okay. Yeah, well, right. Good. So there you go. There you have it from Doc, his final thoughts. Thank you so much. Devil Dog from the Bronx.
Wait.
Final thoughts, brother. What? Wait. Oh, wait.
He's got to prepare himself.
Shout out to Ogre's Hose. I'm done.
Of course. You kidding me? Of course. Ogre's
Hose. Yes. And we hope a speedy recovery to Chuck and Wency and 007. He will definitely be back here next week.
That's it, man.
So
love you guys.
We're going to go back to the Bronx. Devil Dog, final thoughts.
Okay. Final thought. I'm having such a good day, good night. I was part of my wonderful program that we do at the precinct, Cops and Kids. We did that today at a local school. Had a great time. Thank you for my partner, Detective Tejada Carmen. She was there with me, and she was on point with these kids. We had our NCOs there, our community partners. Thank you very much, and we look forward to keep doing it every month with these kids. They need that. They need us in their lives. So shout out to the Cops and Kids, our Big Brothers, Big Sisters program. And to all our veterans, we love you. Stay safe, and God bless you. I salute you guys.
Hoorah, Semper Fi. Good job there, Devil Dog. And my final thought is, again, thank you guys again for watching us tonight. It really makes it really makes our day because, again, like Devil Dog said, people are starting to take notice, and they're reaching out to us to promote what they're doing in the community. So, again, I want to throw this out there to you, too. Let us know if there's something you want us to promote, whether it's the job you work at, something you're doing special in your community. Let us know. We will promote that for you free of charge. Well, like I said, this has nothing to do with money. We're all about veterans taking care of each other, getting each other sick. And again, this also goes out to people who if they really need to speak to somebody, give us a call, man. We're here. I know, Doc can attest to this. I've called him on a couple of occasions where I was having a bad day and I just needed someone to talk to. Same thing with Devil Dog, man. I was like, dude, I'm fucking having a rough day. And he was there for me. So I'm throwing this out there for you as well. I mean, I may not be able to get to you, but at least I'll be that soundboard, man. Just, you know, talk to us. We're here. And if there's something that you want us to share with the world, be our, you know, let us know. Hit me up. Send us an email. Call us 219-232-VETS. Send us an email at BlackSheepBravo@gmail.com. I'll leave up links, but I just want to thank everybody because we're gaining steam. We're getting closer and closer. People are starting to take notice. And
again, we are here for you.
Exactly. And if you have an idea for the show, or if you want to be a future guest, or if you have a future segment, or if you have an idea for a future show that you want to promote and we could promote it for you, give us a call. So on behalf of the Black Sheep Bravo crew, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, this is the Spaniard keeping it tight right here on Black Sheep Bravo. Have a great weekend. Hoorah.
Semper Fi, baby.